Hi, I'm Clara. As you know, I did complete a tutorial of ZipCut and TubePro. If you didn't watch them, please click the link up here. Today, I will show you the models of ZipCut and their differences in functionality and performance. Actually, it's also an idea provided by the comments. Some viewers will confuse why they don't have such function with ZipCut. Before getting into the main chapter, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel and give me your like. Thank you. I will make a brief on ZipCut for those who are not familiar with it. ZipCut is the laser cutting control software launched by Shanghai Friendly's Electronics Technology Co. Limited, which is the most common and practical control system used in fab laser cutting machines. Personally speaking, I'm a fan of it, and they have been constantly innovating to bring more and more practical application software and technologies. Today we'll just show the metal plate cutting systems from 1000 to 8000. You may also call them as ZIP 1, ZIP Cut, and HAP Cut. First, let's see the speed ability. The max idling acceleration from ZIP 1 1000i to HAP Cut 8000, they are 1G, 1.5G, 2G, 2G, and 5G, and is also the same as the max processing acceleration 1G, 1.5G, 2G, 2G, and 5G. The max idling speed and max processing speed for ZIP 1 1000i is 100 M per minute, and the same for ZIP 1 1500A. But for ZipCut 2000 and HAP Cut 8000, there's no limits on the both speeds. On the recommended applicable power, 1000S is for 1000 watt, 1500S is for 2000 watt. ZipCut 2000C is for 1 to 3 kW. 2000S is for 2 to 6 kW. And HAP Cut 8000 is for 6 to 30 kW. Next is the differences in layer parameter settings. The pierce grade is 2 to 5 from 1000i to 8000. If you want to know more about the pierce sighting in ZipCut, please click the video up here. And 1000i is not allowed to have the cooling point, and autofocus and gas pressure DA correction are basic functions for all versions. The instantaneous pierce is only available in 2000i and 8000. And the starting and finishing settings, gas on head, gas flushing, order setting between pre-pierce and defume, and the fine cutting of a single layer are the same, only available in 2009 and 8000. The functions that are only staying with 8000 HAP Cut are pierce and remove slags, instantaneous cutting, auto-checking focus, photo paper detection, vibration suppression adaptive, and the gas diagnosis. The last part is the software capability. First is the functions that are available for all ZipCut versions. Graphics automatic optimization, basic CAD function, basic CAM function, exchange workbench, expand I/O, leapfrog stage, breakpoint memory, and flying cutting. The advertising word production is not available in 8000 system. The ad funding method is automatic except for 1000S, which is manual. Nesting function, 1000S and 1500A are simple. 2000C and 2000S are supported, but they are limited. 8000 is equipped with exclusive nesting software, ZipNest. One button cutoff production report and nozzle cleaning functions are available on 2000C, 2000I's, and 8000 systems. The function of real-time magnification adjustment is not standard for 2000C and 2000S, but optional. The functions supported by 2000I's and 8000 systems are imported files by scanning, adding obstacle avoidance, line cutting function, and maintenance module. The functions supported only by 8000 are blow protection, air pressure closed loop, high speed add winding, and stroke measurement. The software versions we cover today is far from all the versions of ZipCard. The 4000 system has just been released recently, and it has been continuously upgraded. So if you want to know more about the latest news about ZipCard, please click the link in the description below to get to their official website. It will be appreciated if you can click the share button below and let me help more friends who are in searching free and practical knowledge of fabulous cartoon machines. Thank you for your support. It's a great motive to allow me to do more for you. Please don't forget to subscribe me if you are new, and if you still have the time, stick around and see another video. I will see you next Tuesday at 8 p.m. Bye!